Well, among the 200 or so breeds of goats, yes, that's right, goats, across the United States, the San Clemente Island goats are one of the rarest. As Nebraska Public Media's Dennis Kellogg reports, one Nebraska couple is doing all they can to save them.
Welcome to Willow Valley Farms. We're gonna take you guys on a goat walk.
Chad Wegener is a modern day goat herder.
Time for breakfast.
The goats are like family to him. He's gotten to know each one since he left his corporate job to take care of them full time.
I'm part goat. Maybe that was my calling to do this.
There are fewer than 1,500 of these San Clemente Island goats. Threatened with extinction, the largest herd, 250 of them, is located here in Gretna, Nebraska.
It's a nice relationship. I like to keep these guys as feral as possible, as wild as possible, because that's in their nature, and there's something beautiful about it.
The goats get their name from San Clemente Island off the coast of California. There used to be as many as 18,000 of them, but after they overran the island's natural ecosystem, most were eradicated. Now, more than 1,000 miles away, on a 40-acre farm, Chad and his life partner, John Carroll, are doing everything they can to save the breed.
So I think it's really important that, these animals were able to survive on their own for, 100, 125 years. So they know how to survive.
John and Chad are working with breeders across North America. They call this their passion project.
Do you feel a responsibility like you're the last hope for this species?
I do somewhat, yes, because if not us, who? And what we're trying to do is on a larger scale, not just breeding, but on a larger scale to show the world that these goats can have a value. And that's why we want to do a commercial goat dairy.
They think the dairy would be the first ever commercial milking dairy for the San Clemente Island goats. It would include a storefront, cheese room, and a milking parlor.
We feel like if we can do this, we're going to find an outlet for these goats to save them. If they can actually become a dairy goat, those that want to make a boutique niche cheese, the butterfat is very high, and I think it actually will make a really high quality cheese.
They'd also like to build an education center where the main subject would be San Clemente Island goats.
Bring different groups and educate them, whether it's children, at-risk children, LGBTQ youth, local elementary kids. Bring them in and let them see us cheese. Let them help us milk and do some of that in this area.
John adds preserving the genes of these goats could also provide a potential protein source in the future.
Right now, we're focused on beef. That's just what, we're in Nebraska and you eat cows. But we also see our demographics changing, and a lot of the cultures do eat goat and sheep.
Whether it's through meat, milk, or cheese, John and Chad are determined to prove the skeptics wrong.
We just got to figure out how to make it happen. And it takes money, learning how to do it and all that. So we're just inching our way.
Why are you doing it? What are you doing that for? Why are you spending all that money on it? And I think that one day we'll prove them wrong. When I have that goat dairy up and you and I are sitting there eating goat cheese, maybe drinking a glass of wine, we'll toast to this interview and say, told you so.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Dennis Kellogg near Gretna, Nebraska.